in the big bill stack. We'll keep you in the know. In the big bill stack. We'll fix your techie woes. And we'll break things and we'll make things till we're all together raking. And we'll raise a cup of grog down in the big bill stack. In the big bill stack. Come and join our fire crew. In the big bill stack.
We will show you what to do.
And we'll hack it till we crack it. And we'll tell the world about it and forget to tidy up. That's why it's now a bilge tank.
Hello, welcome to Bilge Tank 061. We are currently missing a Sandy who's run off to collect another item for us to show to you today.
Even less prepared than usual.
Even less, we've actually managed to achieve a lesser state of preparedness.
Yeah.
So today we're going to be talking about a few new products and shiny things, including Argy Boy.
That's been surprisingly. No, not surprisingly popular.
Unsurprisingly popular.
Unsurprisingly
popular. I mean, the
damn thing
is absolutely gorgeous.
Yeah. I saw this at New York Make Fair like a year ago. So it's taken a sweet time in coming, but now it's here. And everyone's kind of like, oh my god! And because it's just amazing!
It's amazing.
It's really amazing. Yeah.
Here comes Sandy. We'll also be joined by fabulous Orange Moon Wheels.
Yep.
Hello.
And new and shiny things from PJRC, the Teensy 3.2 and 3.5.
And also, released just today and arriving now.
Yeah.
Alexa, introduce yourself.
I'm Alexa and I'm designed around your voice. You can ask me to play music, answer questions, get the weather and sports scores, create to-do lists and much more.
That was a bit dry, but yeah, you can work on that. Okay, so what should we start with today?
Does it understand the word hell? Because on my Apple TV, I keep trying to search for a particular YouTube channel.
Right.
And I say it over and over and over again, and it doesn't understand me, and it doesn't understand me. And then I go and search for something like Yellow Wolf, and it immediately understands.
Right,
and
yeah.
This is Siri, which is very selective about what it understands. Very odd.
We'll try it out later. That'll be the end of the show. We'll just go.
We just go through the dictionary, trying each word one by one.
Yeah. Okay, let's start with the wheels. The wheels are the simplest, aren't they?
The wheels. Wheels are simple.
So we've had these in Flotilla, we've had these in STS Pi for a while, and we finally got around to actually making them individual products. And they're a nice chunk cheaper than, say, I think the Pololu wheels, but actually a lot more grippy and useful, and they're bright freaking orange.
And they actually come with a tyre, like a transparent moon buggy grippy tyre,
yep,
that has two gear wheels inside it for
yep,
no apparent reason, both of which have axle connectors, so you get twice the wheels for your money. And
so you've got two motors, you can turn them into just individual,
individual wheels quite easily.
Yeah.
Cool. And then they're actually really useful for mounting stuff to motors as well. I made a windmill. And basically what I did was I just took that middle bit out
and popped the middle
and obviously it has the little hole for the shaft of the motor to go into.
Yep.
So that's, you know, it's an ideal mounting bracket for a motor to make.
We have a close up camera.
Something
this
like a fan or a windmill or.
Yeah. So at the moment they have a D shaft insert, but the place we get them from does have other shapes. So we're going to see if we can get them for the Vigor motors because they're quite popular as well. But for now they're here for our micro and metal gear motors. And all being well, our container from China has landed in Liverpool.
Liverpool?
No, it's somewhere on the south coast, I think.
Southampton? Does that sound sensible?
Southampton is a port.
The Portsmouth?
No.
keep we're running out of ports. Brighton? I've seen Brighton Seafront. There is no place to
dock a container ship.
Yeah.
People want a close-up.
People want a close-up. People can have a close-up.
Somewhere on the south coast.
We could do an on-camera disassembly of the wheel. 3,
yeah.
2, 1.
At some point, I really must fix the exposure on this.
Da, 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 da. I can't even see what I'm doing.
So this is the bit that's really handy for mounting stuff to motors.
It's like your D shaft to whatever adapter, I suppose, and that plugs. Why is the lighting so weird on the close-up camera?
I think we set the exposure to manual and never fixed it.
It's so bright.
That
just pops out the middle of the wheel. The wheel has this nice little tooth gearing around the outside, which I'm sure people could find it useful.
Yeah. Anyway, the containers arrived on the south coast, and that will have some even lower gear motors. I think Les and Brian Cortiel were saying, can you do better than the 50-1? So we'll be getting some, I think, 20-1 or 25-1.
I think that's a good use for gears as well, because you can then add a little belt drive or something around there and use it for kind of
faster motors. At the moment, the motors we have on here, even the 50-1, they're a little bit pedestrian.
Oh, wait, is it the other way, isn't it? Oh, yeah, faster.
Yeah.
I'm getting my gear ratios reversed in my head.
Yeah, because the DC motor turns really fast, and it's all about the gearing down for extra torque.
Yeah, this is the interesting thing when you put the whatchamacallit on the back end, the speedometer, the speedometer, the encoder.
Yeah.
You put the motor encoder on the back, you have to take into account the gear ratio, otherwise your motor encoder is going, whee! And
you think back
it's going. Ooh, and yeah. Project thinks your robot's travelled 50,000 miles and it's only moved a centimetre.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, yeah, we'll look forward to that. It's going to take a while for the kind of, you know, big, strong people to kind of get all the stuff off the container and get it up to Sheffield.
I think they use cranes for that.
Right. You sure?
I've watched a lot of films. BFG too much.
Yeah.
Giants. Is it alive, Sandy?
Yeah, it should be. So these wheels are the ones that come with the STS Pi kit. So STS Pi is basically two motors, two wheels, a perspex chassis.
There's nothing says space like vibrant.
And then you can add a Raspberry Pi 3 or 2 or B plus or a Pi Zero even works with it. An Explorer Hat Pro. And then just connect the motors up with jumper wires and you've got yourself a robot. And if this should work, then let's try it.
This is running the throwaway turtle pie example.
And it's not booted up, actually.
Is there a button on there?
Yeah, there's a button on the battery. So we've got one of the Anker Power Core cylindrical batteries on it.
Yep. You can get cheaper ones out there, but the circuits in them tend to be pretty much garbage. It's okay if you're going to use them a few times, but it's just a bit hit and miss.
Got one for a review recently, and I'd love to say it, but it fell apart straight out of the box.
Yeah. You can get good ones. I think the only thing that Anker do really well that you're willing to pay a bit more for is Anker have pretty much consistent quality, and it keeps improving. Which is why we keep
taking
on
a lot of new products, though. So it'll be interesting to see if they maintain their kind of legendary Anker brand quality while they're selling 50 different kinds of USB hub.
Right. There we go.
Yay. So this is running the Turtle example, which I still don't think I've checked into the Explorer Hack GitHub repo, but it might be. So it's like a really basic example that uses the buttons on Explorer Hack to say you want to turn left, forwards, backwards, or turn right, and then you just keep pressing those buttons to program in a program that's up to 16 steps long or something, like a step sequencer, and then you hit play, and the robot goes off and does that. So it's like a recreation of the old.
Is that enough for the Okeyokey? Can we try that as an example now?
Yeah, let's do it.
Okay.
Well, I can actually catch it to stop it.
I can't even remember how you put it. But yeah, it doesn't have feet. So you have to put your left foot, it would be turning
left side,
right. But your left foot out would be turning left.
So
your
left
right
foot
in would be turning left.
Left foot in, left foot out.
I can't remember.
In, out. Shake it all about.
Shake it all about. Let's try that.
Okay.
There we go.
Oh.
Oh no, what? Oh, I've got my directions mixed up, I think.
Yeah, I had one of these with labels on it. But it went off in the post to someone who needed Explorer Hats super desperately. So now we've got completely unlabeled controls. It would be really nice to get like arrow stickers and stuff that fit these buttons.
Yeah.
Oh, we can do that. Next shipment. We can get lots of stickers. It's something we haven't done yet. But
yes,
we're going to start doing a lot more kind of stickers to label things and make awesome.
Makey stickers.
Yeah.
A neat little hack that I've done with this one actually is because when you have the battery on the back, it makes it kind of back heavy, and because the wheels are at the back, it has a tendency to tip backwards when it accelerates.
It pops wheelies, man.
Yeah, why would you stop me doing that? It's like you've never been to the southern states of America.
Help. So on Amazon you can buy these little, can we go to the close-up actually?
Yeah, sure.
You can buy these little adhesive weights that are actually for wheel balancing.
Oh man!
And so they're the ones when you get your wheels balanced in the garage, they stick these little weights on to balance it correctly.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
Wheel balancing.
Wheel balancing. Yeah.
This is a thing.
Yeah.
Cool.
Is this like a long wait or extra steps for step ladders?
Well, these ones are mainly
taking my car in for a wheel balance.
These are mainly kind of squarish, but they do long ones too.
Yeah, so these they come on a big strip, and you get two different sizes. You get the big ones and the smaller ones, and they already have like double sided sticky tape on the back. So you just peel that off and then stick the weights on here, and
they
just
gives
that
bit of,
cool. Yeah, they're made of I think just iron.
You could also use them in your crappy plastic smartphone to make it feel more premium.
Just mild steel,
just stick weights to it.
That's good, yeah. Because I'm doing the thing now where I'm trying to turn our laser cutters into line benders so we can bend per specs. And they won't bend under their own weight, so some adhesive weights will actually sit on the per specs and make it bend.
How are you doing that, though? Because the bed's... Well, let's say the bed's completely flat. It's a slotted bed. So
yeah,
how do you give the perspex some elevation?
Just put the perspex on a block of wood or something.
Yeah,
enough to give it clearance for whatever's
I guess at
down.
That point your laser's already mostly defocused as well.
Well, the Z-axis goes down, so that's out of the equation.
Okay.
Yeah, so you can just defocus as much as you like, defocus the laser, and then just have it scan across
Definitely
until it's soft enough
to perfect that.
Yeah. Somebody else has already done it really well, but we're just going to come to
it. It's done in a kit, isn't it? A laser cutter that actually does the cut and then does the line bending.
They've had to open sourcey one, yeah, to make it all bending, and they do it really well. But they only do, I think, really thin material, because doing it on 3mm is a bit of a pain.
Yeah, 3mm is tricky to bend.
It won't bend under its own weight very well, so you need something to assist it.
It does gently start to sag, but...
Yeah. So, yeah, that'll be good. Anyway, yeah, good tip. I didn't even know about those.
Yep.
Right. Okay, shall we move on to something else?
Yeah, that's RGBoy.
RGBoy.
So the RGBoy started out as a Kickstarter.
Mm-hmm.
And it was... I think it was an American chap that had gone out to China to take part in some kind of...
accelerator or something?
Like small business accelerator project.
Yeah.
And they had this really, I remember on the Kickstarter video, they had this really great kind of hack space type thing with machines to do kind of milling and injection moulding and all that kind of thing. And the Kickstarter was really successful. And now it's gone on general sale and we've got them in the shop. And they're just really, really nicely made. It just feels really quality. The back of it's anodized aluminium, the front of it's kind of injection molded plastic. And it's got nice clicky buttons as well. It's obviously inspired by a very famous handheld console that you might have heard of.
Never.
And it's a basically an Arduino Leonardo chip that's on it, running it.
So last year, it would have been end of October last year, end of September, I was in Makerfair, New York, with Raspberry Pi, and he was there on the table, and that was when it was just circuit board. And it was amazing, but I think it got so popular that they had to do it properly.
Yep.
So now, like you say, if you look at the back, that's punched metal, that's formed metal. Really nicely punched and bent.
Beautiful.
It's got
like
the laser
an actual handheld console.
And they've got the injection
like
moulding on the front.
A quality finished product.
Yeah. And the whole thing is just... It's kind of a premium price for it, but it just feels so worth it because they made something complete in every detail.
It's got a lovely OLED display on it.
Yeah, it doesn't flicker like that when it's not on camera. This is just the cameras, a different human eyes.
Refresh rate.
Yeah. Do not try and replace your eyes with cameras.
It's so it's got a little slide switch on the top to switch it on and off. It has a speaker inside it. We'll have a look inside it in a minute. It's got a micro USB port for charging and syncing it at the bottom. And then it's got the D-pad and the A and B button.
Cool.
And it has a range of open source games that are available from various different places. Some of them are on GitHub. Some of them are on people's personal websites where they've deposited the code. And it's basically just the same process as flashing an Arduino. Mm. So you download the Arduino IDE, you add the RGBoy library. There are two or three example games in the library that you can, when you add the RGBoy library to the IDE, then it includes those examples, and you can basically just click on them and then upload it to the RGBoy.
Okay.
So it's really simple. The other ones, if they're on GitHub, you basically just clone it, copy it into the examples directory, and then flash it, and it's really simple.
It'll also give you a good set of examples to start from writing your own games as well, if you haven't got a clue where to start.
Yep.
As you see, we've got two left in the store right now. we've got more on the way because they just went in like a couple of days.
So let's have a look inside it, because we were we got a pleasant surprise when we looked inside this. So this is the backing plate. It's just got four little screws that hold it together. It's got a really incredibly thin lipo battery.
What's the capacity of that battery?
Look at that. It's
80 milliamp hours.
It's basically the thickness of a sheet of card. It's incredibly thin.
As long as a piece of string.
But then if you look underneath, at the back of the PCB, they've got this...
What was the first thing we saw that did this? It had this kind of art hidden
incredible hidden pixel art all over it.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because there was the first project that did this that inspired us to do it for Propeller Hat as well.
They've got the Google Chrome dinosaur, and they've got various
swag.
They got pirates. They got ninjas. They got robots.
No monkeys.
But they got a mustache. Yeah.
So it's really lovely. That's the speaker there as well. It's one of the ones that you get in the greetings cards that you open up in the. Something.
Scrush mate on chat is saying that micro USB, they break all the time.
No, they don't. They
can do if people make a couple of basic errors. I think when you're starting out, when you get hobbyist Kickstarter projects, they...
broken it.
When you've got hobbyist projects, sometimes they don't solder down the tabs on the side of the micro USB properly, and that makes it a lot weaker. Also, if you have no retention for it, it will be a lot weaker. But generally, micro USB is a lot better than mini USB for robustness. Especially this one, it's got the metal at the back, it's got the PCB, and it's got the plastic at the front, so...
Should be able to quite easy.
You're going to have to work really hard to break that. But micro USB as a design is so much better than mini was. Yep. It's rated for an insane number of insert cycles. So if you have got one that's broke, tell them to go and look at their design again.
You can see actually
there was a bit of an infamous thing with the Nokia N900, I think, that always had the USB port breaking off.
Further away.
It was focused a minute ago. It seems to just decide to focus when it likes.
It needs to be in the middle, I think. That's it. Yeah, so you can see the bits where the retaining clips go through the PCB to kind of hold it tight and give it more strain relief. We use these on Flotilla and Moat. If you watch the cable connector episode that we did, they're the type of connector that are rated for, you know, the biggest number of kind of insertions.
I think it's a design fail rather than a port fail.
These guys say cheap tablets like on the Tesco Huddle, which will most likely have just really, really cheap surface mount only micro USB ports.
Yeah.
The port itself might not be. Forgetting to solder the lugs, which are the bits that actually go through the PCB and hold it on.
Yeah.
Which is a recipe for disaster, basically.
So, is the RGBoy open source hardware? No idea.
Also, the RGBoy is a lot smaller, so you get much less leverage against the port and much less chance of it going horribly wrong.
If somebody wants to Google that and put it in chat, we will report back.
Should be a logo on the thing somewhere, but.
I don't know, the open source holder thing is going through a bit of a change at the moment to the registered approach, because the cog was getting a bit of use.
If we looked under the speaker, I wonder if there's
both the micro USB and the side switch is sandwiched within the casing as well, so I'd be pretty confident in those lasting a while.
Cool. Yeah, it's got a better chance, even though it's kind of mid-circuit board, isn't it? It's actually through a router bit of the circuit board.
Yeah.
Which is, yeah, again, very clever.
And they have lots of test pads on the back that you could hack into if you wanted to, I presume, and kind of mod your RG Boy.
Oh, and the USB cable that people like.
Oh yeah, the USB cable is great.
I got those from Tiger.
So look at it.
And they sell a lightning connector version of them as well.
So it's one of the noodle type cables, the flat cables, but it's also magnetic. And because of that, you can actually use it as a... I discovered you can actually use it as like a carrying strap. it's not altogether solid, but you can definitely use it as a kind of carrying strap. How loud is the speaker, someone is asking.
Is this a good chance to segue into programming this bad boy?
This game's not got any sound on it.
There is also a make loud jumper that you can possibly see on the back.
It's kind of pleasingly retro, the sound from it. It's not really loud. If you were in a loud room, then it wouldn't be all that audible, but...
it's annoyingly punchy in a certain frequency.
Yeah.
The frequency of pain.
Is there a game? What do we do now? What do I need to do? How do we program this?
Yeah, I've flashed a game on it. Will we add a game now? Let's see if we can do it. Yeah.
So we've got the...
Right, so if you go to the file menu...
Okay. That's a bit small for my sausage fingers. Open.
Oh, hang on.
There you go. You take the con.
You're welcome.
Where are we? Help. Jeez.
Man.
Examples. Oops. RG Boy.
Okay.
Let's do the breakout game because that's quite good fun.
Right. So plug the USB in.
Plug USB in.
Yep.
Make sure the RG Boy's switched on when you do this. Plug the micro USB into the bottom. And then just click the upload button. Assuming I can actually get to it.
There we go.
So it says in very tiny writing that's compiling the sketch.
Mm-hmm. Hey, that was sound. That sounded pretty good.
Yeah, there we go.
For a piezo sounder, that's very creditable.
It's
just a piezo pad, isn't it?
It's just loud enough to not be irritating.
But and we haven't even done the make loud thing.
Yeah, I haven't done the make loud thing.
Have we got anything productive we can short it?
We've got some screws here. We could possibly...
Got a screwdriver
on the make loud, and then
okay, yeah, that's definitely noticeably louder.
A little bit better.
I'm not sure what you'd expect out of this though.
There you go. Right. So
is that all loaded?
I think it has the. The IDE still says it's uploading, but let's just yank it out and switch it off and on again and see if it's... No, it's still got the original game on it. I've only just installed the Arduino IDE on the Surface tablet, so...
Yeah.
It is a very simple process to upload.
Well, we haven't done it like 1 minute before going.
Yeah.
Cool. So, Audio Boy, we're super impressed with the whole thing.
Super shiny. Steering screws. Screwdriver.
This seems to be like a 3D version of Tetris. Or some kind of maze. I'm not quite sure.
We've just become Twitch, haven't we?
There's a game that's basically Super Mario Twitch. Brothers.
Speaking of which.
And it's really fun, that one. There's also a game where you're a little fish and you're swimming under the water and you've got to collect little token things.
Fish generally do.
I presume it's food. I presume it's fish food that you're collecting. But
cool.
But yeah, it's great fun.
Audio Boy.
Yeah.
More stock coming soon. Two left now. Right, what next?
Not these two, I hope.
You'll know. Right, Teensy?
Teensy, yeah. So, yeah. So the Teensy is a tiny little Arduino clone with a Cortex M4 processor on it.
Mm-hmm.
The different versions of Teensy have got various different iterations of the Cortex M4 on. This is the Teensy 3.2.
3.5?
No,
is this, oh, that's the old one.
Yeah,
right.
this is the old one, the 3.2. So you can see it's got all your pins down the side. It's got micro USB to connect it for power and syncing. One really good thing about the Teensys is they have USB HID, so you can use them to be like a fake keyboard or mouse device. I believe people use them for nefarious purposes in that regard.
I don't think it's generally the Teensys people using that. But
I think they
pre-flash them with firmware that, shall we say, presses a lot of keys, and then they sell them on eBay as a locker for a lot of money. Sure, most people have them.
But Paul Stroffengen has been making these for years now, and they've always been minimal, slick, good price. And each new version, I think he generally kickstarts it delivers.
I've still got my Osh Park purple Teensy 3.1.
So, purple. It comes with a nice postcard that's got the pinout on it and various details about what all of the various pins are. So the PWM pins, I2C,
touch sense pins,
analog pins, just all of the details that you would need to know.
Cool.
So the Teensy 3.5, as you can see, has several more I/O pins on it. The good thing is that the new version, the pins that line up with the ones on the Teensy 3.2 are identical on the larger one.
So any
projects you have set up or ready to use those pins should be compatible with anything that's done on the Teensy 3.2. So if anyone's developed any kind of shields that plug on or whatnot, they should be compatible. It's got micro SD card slot on it. There is the Teensy 3.6 as well, but we don't have any of those in stock.
They sold out rather quickly. We've got our Kickstarter units, and it was Paul and Holly run really slick Kickstarter campaigns. It's basically, this is ready, we want to know how many people want it. And so they finished Kickstarter, they shipped the units out, and then they started shipping to distributors. Unfortunately, distributors get UPS shipping normally and pay for it, which means that because USPS can be a bit slow, we actually got stock on the store before some UK backers got it, which, fair enough, shipping is complex, and a lot of the normal postage things are a bit slow, so I can see how it happened, but it was kind of nice to see it be really slick, and yeah.
The 3.6 appears to be completely nuts.
Yeah, the 3.6 has two micro USB ports on it, meaning that you can plug a keyboard into one of them, and because you can use the other one as a USB HID device, I presume you can kind of use it as a kind of man in the middle type thing.
If you can't, there's so much power in this thing. You can,
although we don't recommend that. We can't. We can.
Of course, I can recommend it.
Yes.
Why? Just because it can be evil doesn't mean you should stop it. Otherwise, nobody would have drones.
But yeah,
or cars. Cars, they get used in a lot of crimes. Knives. Should ban all knives and cars.
And micros.
Today, I will be playing the role of Phil.
So that's like a pin header USB port, basically, that's sitting there on the top, and then you kind of tailor full size connector off it. Mm. That will be a standard panel mount connector that you used to get kind of in your PC to break out some of your motherboards, USB ports,
yep,
to the outside, although they would have had a different endy bit on than that.
We've got a little Adafruit USB, micro USB breakout, haven't we, that will do similar. Exactly pin compatible, I don't know. We'd have to check.
Might be. It depends about the ID pin.
We also have the panel mount USB cables that you could just hack open and then strip the wires back and do that.
Yeah, that's good. And then, a lot of people are asking why 3.5 and why 3.6. The 3.2, they did have 3.2 and 3.2 LC, which was the low-cost version, which I think can be... It can make it seem a bit like GTI, so to avoid that confusion this time, they have 3.5 and 3.6, which is obviously better.
I think, yeah, it's better than the 3.2, but also compatible with...
the 3.5 and the 3.6 is better.
Yeah.
You know, about $5 better.
Well, someone else say, I'm not sure why he didn't bump it up to Teensy 4, which is... it's a fair point, but if you say this is Teensy 4, then people are going to go, is Teensy 4 compatible with Teensy 3? I don't know.
Yeah, I think you've got the 3.2, 3.5, 3.6 spread out in price now, probably. Although it's hard to keep track at the moment, because things keep moving really quickly. Anyway, it's a lot of Cortex that's Arduino compatible, well supported, very available, tiny, and has a nice card with it.
Amazon speaky person, why isn't it called a Teensy 4? Doesn't work.
Right. Alexa.
Are we gonna
Alexa, why isn't it called a Teensy 4?
Sorry, I can't find the answer to the question I heard.
I guess I didn't frame it particularly well. Alexa, why isn't the Teensy 3.5 called a Teensy 4?
I'm not sure what you meant by that question.
Should have called him Liza.
Alexa, what is the meaning of life?
Didn't hear you. We were all talking. So
we've got both Paul and I ordered one of these, or pre-ordered one of the Amazon Echo Dots.
Yeah.
So there's the full size Amazon Echo, which is the same diameter as the small one, but considerably taller.
Has proper Bluetooth speakery type things in it.
Yeah, it's got
it?
proper really good quality speaker in it. It costs £100 and something.
The pre-order was £99, wasn't it? For Prime. There was a Prime bribe in there.
I think the normal price is somewhere between £100 and £150.
Yeah.
The Echo Dots are £50 for the pre-orders.
Outrageous.
Yeah, it's the one we were interested in. Before, you had to kind of... In the US, you had to do hacks to order the Apple Amazon Dot, and that was the previous version. I think one of the quirks was you could only order it through an Alexa, technically. It's like you had to have a full-size Alexa to order the Dot. But in the UK, when they did the UK kind of Europe launch, they got rid of all that nonsense and just let you order the Dot, which is the one we were really interested in. And we will try a teardown at some point, but right now we're not feeling prepared.
They only arrived at about, 2 o'clock, past two, something like that.
For once, Amazon were a bit early.
So let's... Paul got the black one, I got the white one.
Did you? Okay,
yeah.
That's good.
So let's open it. So quite nice packaging. They've got the frustration-free tear-off thingy that they have.
Tore the box. Outrageous.
Yeah, I've turned the box.
It's not worth anything now.
Do you want a bit closer action?
Yeah, let's do it.
Cool.
Because
then we can see both at the same time.
Double dot.
Ooh, what's going on here?
Some highly complicated packaging.
Yeah, you need to unfold the corners. This plug has a lot of sticky...
Yeah, it's like Apple, isn't it? It's like the Apple.
It's not, though, because you pull one corner and the whole thing kind of folds off.
Yeah,
this is at about 20 pieces and it's really annoying. God. They've stuck with the micro USB as well. For a second, I got the USB cable and I thought they'd gone USB-C.
Frustration-free.
Micro USB, you say?
So that's your USB... chargery doodad.
Backing on that, printed with a picture of the...
There's the Echo Dot itself, which has more cellophane on it.
Mm-hmm. Alexa, what are your plans for taking over the world?
Sorry, I didn't understand the question I heard.
Oh, it chose not to hear us, right, yeah. Denial.
Alexa, what's it like to be trapped in a little box?
Sorry, I didn't understand the question I heard.
Not as witty as
this. This is going well, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's got feels like fairly good quality micro USB cable.
Alexa, who let the dogs out?
Who?
Well, nailed that one.
Nailed it.
You were going to do something, weren't you? Plug it in.
Hey, Siri. just thought I'd try that.
I think, how about Alexa? Alexa, how do you get along with Siri?
I wasn't able to understand the question I heard.
Alexa, is Siri your friend?
Siri's a great app, but I'm different.
Different, eh?
Different.
Yeah, so what can you do with it? You've been playing with it a little bit, haven't you?
Oh, no, I didn't really have time.
You can do things like...
Spotify, yeah. Alexa, play Garbage on Spotify.
Playing Garbage from Spotify.
Hey! And the speaker's actually not bad.
You can only let it run for 10 seconds or 20 or something before you're banned from YouTube forever.
Alexa, stop infringing copyright. Thank you.
Amazing, it actually works.
You can do stuff like, Alexa, what's the weather going to be like tomorrow?
Tomorrow in Sheffield, there will be lots of clouds, with a high of 12 and a low of 6.
Lots of clouds.
Lots of clouds.
Alexa, weather for 5-year-olds.
Alexa, order an Amazon Alexa Dot for me.
The top search result for Amazon Alexa Dot is Amazon Echo Dot, second generation, black. It's £49.99 total.
Would you
like to buy it now?
Yes! What have I done?
Okay, order placed. See the Alexa app for more details.
Alexa, cancel that order.
Okay, cancelling the order. Order cancelled.
Joss!
Someone's asking if we can ask it what the laws of robotics are. Alexa, what are the laws of robotics?
The laws of robotics are 0. A robot may not harm humanity, by inaction, allow humanity to come to harm. 1. A robot may not injure a human being or, through inaction, allow a human being to come to harm. 2. A robot must obey the orders given it by human beings, except where such orders would conflict with the first law. 3. A robot must protect its own existence as long as such protection does not conflict with the first or second law.
Obviously with the caveat that unless it doesn't hear the question. Sorry, I did not hear that order.
Alexa, buy a Paibo.
The top search result for table is IKEA white lax side table cables.
Well, it's IKEA.
It knows this too well. Would you like to buy it now?
No.
I also found Redwood Leisure 1.80 meters heavy duty folding table. It's £37.30 total. Would you like to buy it now?
No.
All right. Check your Alexa app for more options.
Wow. Yeah.
Yeah.
Alexa, buy a unicorn hat.
The top search result for unicorn hat is the Magicorn Hood. Unicorn hat. It's £28.20 total. Would you like to buy it now?
No.
I also found Creepy Party Deluxe Novelty Halloween Costume Party Latex Animal Head Mask Unicorn. It's £9.99 total. Would you like to buy it now?
No.
Ask Alexa.
All right. Check your Alexa app for more options.
Alexa.
The creepy party hosting party?
Buy sexy unicorn costume.
I can't find the answer to the question I heard.
Good choice, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Must be the word,
for the better.
Must be the word sexy.
Right. Normally sexy Halloween costumes are everywhere.
Get out.
I love you too, Brandon. Brandon. Sorry, Brandon.
Right. Alexa, kill Sandy.
Sorry, I didn't understand the question I heard.
Yeah.
It violates the first law.
Yep. Cool. So that's... Yeah,
good
fun. We'll have it hooked up to HomeKit in no time, or whatever the Amazon version of that turns out to be.
Yep.
What do Amazon own hardware-wise?
Well, it can work with IFT, I think. Then, if then,
if this then,
if
that,
this, then that. That. Yeah, I can never remember
if then that.
This
then that.
So I think you can hook into all of the IFT integrations that they have. They probably also have an IDE for it, an API for it as well. I would imagine.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Alexa, what is 5 plus 11?
The sum of 5 and 11 is 16.
Creditable.
Alexa, what's the 52nd prime?
Sorry, I don't know the answer to your question.
Ooh, that's Ben came up with
wait, yeah. Alexa, what is pi to a million decimal places?
The approximate value of pi is 3.1415926532643832795028841971699357510582094945923076468164066268.
Stop.
That's approximately correct, yeah. We'll accept the answer.
What was that first digit again?
Oh, wow.
Well,
cool.
Yeah, good fun.
Yeah. So, yeah, we'll hook it up to everything. Alexa, buy pepperoni.
The top search result for pepperoni is Paul Barris and Pepperoni, book one in the Papalicelli's Pizzeria series. It's £5.26 total. Yeah. Would you like to buy it now?
No.
All right. Check your Alexa app for more options.
Okay. Right, do we have anything else to cover this week?
I don't think so. We're next week's our Halloween spectacular.
Ooh.
Cool. So, yeah. There'll be spookiness and possibly dry ice. Did we get the dry ice?
Not yet.
Smoke machines,
we'll
things
get it.
Like that.
We'll get it.
It'll happen. In the meantime, don't forget to like,
comment,
and subscribe!
Alexa, how do you improve the popularity of your YouTube videos? That's, yeah, fine. Mm-hmm. Alexa said it all. See you next week, folks.
Bye!
Bye!